Hello, I welcome you all in this course on power plant engineering. Today in this lecture we will discuss what are the prerequisites we required to learn about the particular subject, course objectives, course outcomes and syllabus. Prerequisites. We required some basic concepts of applied thermodynamics, means first law of the thermodynamics, second law of the thermodynamics, like this, thermal engineering, internal combustion engines. What will be there in the internal combustion engines? One is the diesel engine and petrol engine, and one more is the heat transfer. These are the some of basic concepts we required for the particular subject. Course objectives. The course is aimed at providing knowledge of power generation through different primers. What are the primers we have? Steam, ICGT, what is ICGT? Internal combustion and gas turbine, hydro, nuclear and hybrid systems, along with their economics and environmental considerations. Course outcomes. After undergoing this course, the student can understand various conventional methods of power generation. What are the conventional methods here? Diesel generators, gas turbines, hydel power plant, nuclear power plants. These are the some of conventional methods to generate power. And next one is the principle of operation and performance of respective primers, along with their economics and their impact on environment. Now we are going to be discuss the syllabus. See, the purpose of the first unit 1 here, the purpose of this chapter is to introduce the learners about introduction to the source of energy and what are the resources and development of power in India, what are the different type of resources. It means what? Resources means what? We already discussed in the, we will discuss in the upcoming lectures. What are the resources, what we have, how we are going to be develop power. What is development of power? There are a number of plans will be there, 5-year plans. That and all we will discuss in the upcoming lectures. Next one is the steam power plant and plant layout. Working of different circuits, fuel handling equipment. What are the different type of poles? Bitumen's coal, anthracite coal, like this will be there. How you have to handle the coal, choice of handling equipment, how we can store the coal, in-plant storage and out-plant storage, and ash handling system. After coal will be burned, there will be ash will be available. So how can we handle the ash combustion? Properties of coal, overfeed, underfeed fuel beds, traveling rate stockers, spread stockers. So traveling stockers is nothing but to put the coal into the combustion chamber. That for that the stockers are used. Next one is the retort stockers. Next one is the pulverized fuel burning system and its components. Next one is the combustion units and draught systems. Draught system is here induced draught, forced draught, fans, cyclone furnace, design and construction, dust collectors, cooling towers and heat rejection. Next one is the corrosion and feed water treatment. See here how much number of classes we required. These are the test book or reference books with the page numbers we are given. Next we are entered into the unit 2. So what is the purpose unit 2 here? Internal combustion engines. We will discuss internal combustion, introduction and diesel power plant. How the diesel power plant will be there. How the plant, how can we plan the plant layout. Design the plant layout with the auxiliaries. Fuel supply systems, air starting requirement, supercharging. These are all the topics will come under the category of internal combustion engines. Now, gas turbine power plant. The gas turbine is the one of the oldest device known to man for the conversion of heat into mechanical work. So here we will discuss about introduction to the gas turbine power plant, classifications, constructions, layout with the auxiliaries. Next is the combined cycle power plant and compressor. Combined cycle power plant means here both will be combinedly operating, diesel power plant and as well as the gas turbine power plant, both will be combined together and it will be operating. That is combined cycle power plant and their comparison we will discuss. Next we will enter into the unit 3. This is the hydroelectric power plant. So what is the purpose of this chapter is to introduce the learners. It plays very important role. The hydroelectric power plant plays a very important role in the development of the country as it provides power at the cheapest rate. Next, here we will discuss about water power, hydrological cycle. Next one is the flow measurement, drainage area characteristics, hydrographs, storage and pondage, classification of dams and spillways. Next, Here, hydro projects and plants, classification, typical layouts, plant auxiliaries, plant operation. Auxiliaries means what are the different equipments, what will be components, what will be there in the entire layout, and what their operation, and pumped storage plants. Now we are entering into the unit 4. Here we will discuss about the nuclear power stations, nuclear fuel, breeding and fertile materials, nuclear reactor, reactor operations. There are different type of reactors will be there, pulverized water reactor, boiling water reactor. Along with this, there will be sodium graphite reactor, fast breed reactor, homogeneous reactor, gas cooled reactor, radiation hazards and shielding radioactive waste disposal. So see why the shielding we require. After combustion will be done here, what will be happen? There will be radiation hazards will be there. So how can we prevent? With help of shielding. That also we will discuss. So after combustion, after power attraction will be, we are taking power from the from the nuclear power stations. There will be radioactive waste disposal. Where it will be going to be disposed? That also we will discuss. Next, we will enter into the unit 5. Here, combined operation of different power plants. So, in the earlier what we will discuss, introduction, advantage of combined working, load division between power stations, storage types. This we will discuss. Next, combination of hydroelectric power plant in combination with the steam plant. Here, both hydro power plant and steam power plant, both combination we will discuss. Next is the runoff river plant in combination with the steam plant. So, we know steam plant. What about runoff river plant? So, here in the runoff river plant, no water storage at all. Here, there is no water will be stored separately. There is no dam requirement will be there. Or limited amount of storage, in which if it is a limited amount of storage will be there, in which case the storage reservoir is referred to as a pondage. Next will be coordination of hydro, electric and gas turbine stations. Next, coordination of hydro, electric and nuclear power station. These are the combinations we will discuss. Next, coordination of different types of power plant. That also we will discuss. Next one is the power plant instrumentation and control. See here, importance of measurement and instrumentation in power plant. That we will discuss. Next, measurement of water purity. We will check the how the water will be, purity of the water and the gas analysis, O2 and CO2 measurements, measurement of smoke and dust. Next, measurement of moisture in carbon dioxide circuit. Next one is the nuclear measurement. These are the measurements we will take from this particular unit 5. That will be a power plant information control is the part B in the unit 5. Next, we will enter into the unit 6. What we will going to be discussing here? Power plant economics and environmental considerations. Here, so we will discuss what is the capital cost, investment and fixed charges, operating cost, general arrangement of the power distribution. We will discuss about the load curves, load duration curves, how we are consuming the power. We can show with help of a load curves. How the power will be developing, that also we will discuss. Definition of connected load, what are the different type of connected loads, that we will discuss. Maximum demand, demand factor, average load, load factor. We will discuss diversity factor and related, we will do some exercise problems, related exercise problems also we will do. And next we will discuss the effluents from the power plants and impact on environment. What are the different effluents will be coming from the power plant and how it will be impact on environment. Next we will go through the pollution and what are the pollution standards, national and international pollution standards we will discuss. Next one is the methods of pollution control. See here, it is a test books. This entire syllabus will be covered by the course in power plant engineering, Aurora and Domukundu and Dhanapatha Rai. This test book is enough to cover entire syllabus, and if it is any topics will be missed, that will be, we can go through the test book to power plant engineering, PC Sharma. It's a Kataria publication. There are some other reference books will be there. You can go through it, the reference book. Power plant engineering by P. Kena, power station engineering by J. Wakil, McGarville. And an introduction to power plant technology, GD, right? So other other references also will be there. This can also will be available. So that's all for today. Thank you very much.